What's up? What's going on, guys? Nashawn Garrett here. If you don't know me, how's it going? Nice to meet you. Nashawn, like nation. Nashawn in the Hebrew. That's true. Matthew chapter 1, verse like 5 or 6. I don't know. Somewhere in the genealogy that no one actually reads. But it's actually pretty significant, and there's a reason why it's in there. Anyways, not to get caught up in a rant, I just got a tripod, which is actually pretty sweet.
A little off right here, so let me focus on it.
I kind of like that angle a little bit better. Bam. Alright, I had an awesome time in Chico. Do a quick recap. I went to a farm.
We're out here on the farm.
I ate In-N-Out. I gave a little bit of a synopsis of what In-N-Out is and everything like that. And honestly, let me just be real. I've been really trying. So honestly, In-N-Out is like one of the most satisfying meals. Yeah, I don't like to eat it all the time, but when you do eat it, it's sad when it's gone. If you like In-N-Out, there's nothing wrong with it. I enjoy In-N-Out just as much as the next person. Stop acting like In-N-Out's the best burger place. It's not. And if you believe it is, you obviously haven't been any actual good burger place. It is cheap. It is nice. It is classic. The environment, there's a kind of harmony there. There's an atmosphere that In-N-Out provides. I advertise for Martinelli sparkling apple juice cider. Wayne got sparkling apple cranberry or apple juice Martinelli's, then you ain't at a party. Very good. Give me free stuff, please. Wingmaned heavily for two of my good family friends who are single, and they live, one lives in Chico and one lives in Arizona. Maybe I'm giving too much detail. Sorry about that, guys.
Had at least two single women here in the Pritis family. They have to find by their singleness, though. This is exactly why they're single.
Don't listen to him.
Okay, don't listen to me. It's the pancakes. They look a lot darker on the video, but she burned some of them, honestly.
Mine are good. Mine are really good. See?
Yeah. Those look okay. They're too thick.
They didn't. Me.
No syrup. She don't do syrup. So that's her issue. Everyone's got issues. Girl, you ain't eat. Alright, hold up. Let me. I saw some goats. Goat petting. Oh, they're running away.
Oh!
Did not know a goat's butt looked like that. I saw some people. Let me get this. Let me get the double leg. Get that double leg. I have a New Year's inspirational talk. So here's why I think people like New Year's so much. 2017, 2018, 2016, 2017, your reality is now marked. And what that means is that there's something different about this new year. And people feel that and people receive that and they accept, yes, yesterday was different. I can't live by what happened in 2017. What happened in 2017 was in the past. We're in a whole completely different year. Now, a lot of times we don't really think like that. We can actually live like that on a daily basis. 2017 was in 2017. It's in the past. Most people live from what's happened in the past. They've been hurt in the past. They've experienced something good, something bad, whatever it is, and they allow their experience, their feelings, what's happened or has not happened to dictate for them what could or could not happen. What I love about New Year's is that it's the one time everyone's minds, in some sense, in some way, in some form, gets into this place where they're no longer thinking about the past. They're now thinking forward about what could happen and what could be. Most people are saying, yes, I want to make change. Even if they know they're not going to do it, even if they know they're going to put that 10 pounds back on after they lose in the gym, everyone's in some sense motivated because they know no longer will their past define them. And it would be weird to allow what happened then to affect you now. But in my opinion, we can live like that every day. When we get this thing that we do, but one time on December 31st, we can get that same mentality and if we can apply it to every day, I think we can actually accomplish a great deal more and be way more effective about it. I hope you enjoy tonight. I'll let you guys in on some of the rest of the things that I did. Welcome. Happy New Year's.
Because
I am actually going to Colorado next week, and I'm going to be doing a vlog about my 5, 6, 7 days there. The Olympic Training Center, which is going to be awesome and pretty amazing. So I'll be able to talk to, for my wrestling fans, some of your favorite wrestlers, some of the people that you look up to, and get to show you a little bit one-on-one, like how I hang out with them, what I look like when I'm with them. Oh, I'm looking at, you know, Jordan Burroughs, like, oh. I just love Jordan Burroughs, he's just awesome. But, and I want to let you guys know that my next vlog is going to be off the hook, so please don't miss it. Make sure you check up, not this week, but next week. It's going to be all good and ready to go next. Not this Wednesday, but the coming Wednesday. So have a great day. Yeah, bye.